Come on, Gus. Be a good boy. He is tired. Oh, I love him. Okay. Let's go like that. So we are live. Oh, the world's cutest pug. Just hit the mic. I've got a banana. It's so sticky. Guess, what's this? Easy, guys. Well, Gus, you have to clean my hands. Wait, wait, there's banana on my fingers. Gus. Gus, please. There's banana on my fingers. Just eat it. There we go. Oh, he's so sleepy. I guess I'll just wipe it on my towel. So I'll give him a little head massage. You look so cute. I love my Gus Gus.
He's getting
it. Stop. Oops. Sorry. Gus, that's really loud. Nasty. You want to give me a kiss? Oh, I think he wants to jump off. Oh, yeah, absolutely. A mouth guard for... Oh, actually? I mean, if you do it, I probably just fall asleep, so I don't realize. Oh, Gus. Probably from like the muscles tensing up so much and probably goes into.
Oh, did you get my package?
Oh, yeah. Sorry, I'm tearing the two things over there. Oh. In my gym bag. You'll see there, I slipped them in. There's two of them.
Should I do a little unboxing?
Yeah, sure. Well, ASMR unboxing. Yeah, sure. Yeah, oh, God. Yes, careful. There's a wire. It's the most chaotic stream ever.
I treated myself to something I really need.
What's in it? You should probably cover your address. So. Something for sewing?
Yeah. Something that I really need.
Here, you know what? Let me put the mic on you. Ooh, that sounds good.
Is that too loud?
That's super loud.
Oh my God. Oh, that hurt my tooth.
That hurt my ears.
If you guess right, I'll give you a blowjob.
Okay, wait. You said it was for someone?
Yeah. $1 million question.
And something you needed, or is it something from one of your projects?
something I needed, like, badly.
Okay, you have to give me some hints. Is it some kind of tool?
It's a tool.
Is it, like, goes on the machine?
No, that's all the hints I'm giving you. Five, four, three, two.
Is it a new pair of scissors?
Oh, fuck.
Oh, what the fuck?
Uh-oh.
I guess I gotta end the stream soon.
Ollie's having fun tonight.
What do you mean tonight?
JK, he goes to work. Yeah, I bought a new pair of scissors.
I'll take a rain check on it.
Hot forged. Multicolor titanium. Lifetime warranty. Anyways, I hope these are good because they're made for like tough materials. Because my scissors are all fucked up and they've got like nicks in them. Am I not supposed to swear?
Yeah, it's better for me, but realistically not that many people are watching, so it doesn't really matter.
Well, my scissors are all messed up. I don't know how to open this. I wish I had a pair of scissors.
If you push the scissors into the cardboard, it'll pierce it. Yeah, backwards.
I almost just, like, cut my finger.
Oh, for real?
Yeah. Really heavy.
Should we like?
They're really pretty.
Why don't you do some cutting sounds into the mic?
I don't have any fabric though. You can't just cut anything with these.
No, I mean just like the.
Should I cut your thing?
No, please don't.
Oh, where is it? Oh.
Oh, here, check it out. Let's see. If you can see the mic, but you got to do it on this side. That sounds nice. Let me put the volume up a bit. Here, let me do it.
Be careful, Ghost Kid.
I love that. Oops. I love that sound. That's why I wanted my phone.
Oh, well, I don't know where your phone is.
But either way, most of my viewers are afterwards, yeah. So when I stream, I pretend like I'm talking to people because I know people are going to watch it afterwards. So.
Yeah, these seem pretty nice. They kind of look a little cheap, like, around here, though. If I'm being pretty honest. And there is, like, I just kind of like wiped it off, but there's like some rust starting.
Seriously?
Yeah, like right here and like just like right here kind of looks a little cheap. So, I mean, it was Amazon. I got them off Amazon, so they're not like $100 pair of scissors, you know?
Mm-hmm. That might be oil though. Or is that?
They're a little.
Yeah, I think that's oil because it's coming off. Or grease, I should say.
As smooth as I thought they would be.
Well, it is Amazon at the end of the day.
Yeah. But I mean, I'll know once I cut some stuff. They feel really sharp. I don't have any fabric though to cut anything. There is like a small like nick I can kind of see.
This dog once had bananas so bad. Another one.
Anyways, they were only like $20, so I mean, realistically, I should probably really invest in like $100 pair.
That's weird. He's staring at the camera.
I know, that was weird.
That was really weird. You noticed it too,
right? Yeah, I did.
That was super weird.
That was creepy.
That was actually very creepy. Don't worry, I guess we still love you. So,
I actually think I'm gonna eat the rest of that banana because I'm pretty hungry.
Well, he was pulling on it hard.
Can you hear it?
A little bit more like this. You have to really talk into it that way.
My ASMR debut.
Sounds nice.
Yeah.
Oh no.
Anyways, you fucked up the bottom, so I'm not gonna eat it. Because it's all smushy. Oh wait, my other package.
Okay, wait. Let me turn the volume down. Wait. Pop the overwrap stuff a little bit. Does it pop?
No, I'm gonna probably have to open it first. I really shouldn't be using my teeth, so I think that's how I got a bunch of chips in my teeth on the bottom. No, they're not popping. Do you want to try?
Yeah.
Oh wow, this is so small. Little package.
Oh yeah, I've seen bubble wrap. This is not the poppable kind. I think they make it now so you can't pop it. So that it's like better quality. You know?
Yeah. And I also bought, wow, this is like really sticky.
Yeah, I think I want to do more ASMR, honestly. But not like mouth sound stuff, but like paper sounds. That's the stuff I like, you know?
Yeah.
Like, I love watching, if I can't sleep at night, I'll watch a video of someone doing woodworking. And it gets me really sleepy, you know?
Gets you off?
Yeah, I'm like, oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. We're kind of streaming.
And I also bought... Jesus Christ.
Was a super
chalk. This better be good because, like, I have no chalk.
What's this for?
For sewing.
Oh, for drying.
It smells like... And it feels kind of okay. Like...
This dog wants to go down.
Wow. It smells...
How much hair is on me?
It's pretty good.
Let's see if we can get him. That is too low. You can just see his head in the corner. Let's see.
It's like real chalk. Like sidewalk chalk.
Oh yeah, you can smell it. Ooh, it smells kind of gross.
I mean, as long as it comes off though, with the I mean, it was only $4, so I'm not expecting this to be the best chalk in the world.
Here, can you hold this?
You can't see it. Can you hear it though?
You're like destroying my ears.
Sorry, can you hear it? Oh, you can see it. But B.
I think that's like. Wait, you gotta do it on this side. Ooh, nasty. He's a fat boy, he is. He's a fat boy, yes, he is. Enjoy. He's a fat boy, yes, he is. He's a fat boy, yes, he is. You can. Go to sleep, little pug. Yeah, yeah. Recycle it. That's so disgusting. Oh, look, a piece of banana. I think that's... Oh, he's so cute. I love my Gus Gus. Oh, fuck. You know what? Let me switch this to So it's two sides, so now I can do. So, oh, this is very cool. Oh no, Gus, you're pulling on the thing. He's trying to clean himself. Yeah, sure, go ahead. Actually, no, don't tell me. I don't want to know. Oh. So cute. It, that's normal. It's always like that. Thing doesn't automatically focus.
Great.
Okay. Well, I'll give you a plug.
Sure.
So, Calibre Tech Design.
It's Cal Tech Gear, capital K-E-L Tech Gear, and I made a video, my first video, on how to sew a bag, a little zippered pouch, corduroy pouch.
And I guess you can take a moment to just say, like, what you do in terms of, like your technical. Well, yeah, I'll let you say here.
I make bags and clothing prototypes. Oh, sorry. I make bags and clothing prototypes.
Not too close.
God damn it. And all my bags are made to order and custom. And I focus mostly on bouldering chalk bags and chalk buckets. And my duffel bag is really popular. And I just made a tote bag, which is actually really popular too. I've gotten a lot of orders for that. I do wholesale orders. So, oh, right, I should probably show my bag. I have one.
In the meantime.
his treat bag.
This is his treat bag. So this is was the prototype.
Just switch the mic. Okay.
Sure, sorry. This was the prototype. So it's inches, and this is his hot dogs because they're super wet. But you can hook it on a belt. I don't know if you can see, but there's belt loops. Or you can attach it to your belt, like a hook or something, anything. There's a spot for keys, or if you want to hang anything off there, there's a spot for poop bags. And a spot for your weed. Just kidding. I can't get it open. I'm having a hard time because it's like mirrored, so I don't know what I'm touching. It's like when I try and fix my hair, it's like mirrored and I can't.
You know, you could technically just look at the bag.
Fuck you.
Anyways, just break your brain.
Anyways, that's my treat bag. And it's very popular too. I am the only, not the only, but...
One of the only...
one of the only people making treat bags that's like by hand and not in like a...
Yeah.
A lot of companies will a lot of companies will have a design in house, and you know they say it's made somewhere, and it probably is, but it's made like usually in a factory, so it's outsourced. They'll send all their fabric and material to a big company, and usually one of the easiest ways you can tell if it's by a company, I mean outsourced, is the price. So if it's outsourced, they can usually sell it at a lower price.
Yeah, that's true.
So that's why the treat bags in the stores, now you find that like Mondo are like 15 or 20 bucks. They're probably, you know, made in bulk somewhere. I'm the only one that I know that's making them by hand, custom made in Quebec.
Mm-hmm.
But there's a lot of other talented bag makers in Quebec, and there's a lot in the States. So there's a lot of talented bag makers out there. There's a guy I follow on Instagram who makes dog bowls, waterproof dog bowls. It's really cool.
I didn't know that.
Yeah. I mean, if he lived around here, I'd definitely order one, but I'm not ordering from the States.
Oh, shoot. My camera just turned off.
Wow.
Because it's a DSLR. It
does it turn off
sometimes? Yeah, it has like
a timer.
Yeah. I think it's every 15 minutes I have to turn my camera back on. It's so annoying. Yeah, it just pauses. Because what I'm doing for to have like this isn't a webcam, so it's I'm actually like using thing you saw before, this thing,
mm-hmm.
this, and I'm capturing that for this video.
Nice.
Yeah. Oh, this boy is sleepy.
He's tired. We just had a training session outside.
Yeah, he's so sleepy.
And he's really tired. He's reading books.
That big guy. He's the original humongous.
We're both pretty tall. And we're not like really small people. And he makes us look small.
He literally makes me look like I'm like 5'1".
Yeah, he makes me look like I'm like tiny.
I'm almost 6 foot though. Almost.
So am I.
Almost. I'm like 5'11 and a half, so I'm like missing in centimeters. It's like just like a little bit, but it's okay.
I'm 5'8 on the dot, like right on the dot. Like I've measured myself in centimeters.
Me, it's I'm almost 6 foot, but then my body was like, you know what, just to piss you off, we're gonna keep you on record at 5'11. Oh, really?
Because I did it when I was, like, all my stuff when I was a teenager. And then I had, like, really bad posture when I was a teenager.
Yeah, that was for me, too.
And I, like, marked myself down as 5'7". But then when I, like, grew up, when I got older and I started exercising and I corrected my posture, I was actually 5'8".
Yeah. Yeah, me too. I thought I was short my whole life till I started doing circus and dance and my body got straight and I was like, oh wow, I'm actually kind of tall.
I was like tall when I was in elementary. I was like the tallest girl in elementary. Taller than a lot of the teachers too. But then like when I got to high school, around grade 10 and 11, everybody started catching up.
I'm gonna go like this. Yeah, so it catches everything around. Yeah, like you really feel your body pull you down.
I'm like, oh shit, I'm a heavy bitch.
Oh, you know what I just realized? Mm-hmm. You see that thing there?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah. Can you turn, if you go there and you turn it on, it's gonna add an extra light.
Imagine my tail slipped out. Like that?
It's just a small ring.
Right. Can I have another ring light?
Yeah, sure. It's down there. Yeah. Wait, don't do that now. It's gonna make so much noise. I mean, yeah, just don't like make everything go like.
I would like to use one when I go live on Instagram.
Oh, yeah, no problem. And there's a little stand that comes with it too.
I think I might try and go live today on Instagram.
Oh, cute.
We still have to walk outside too. He's gonna like die.
My baby, I love him.
Soon we'll be out walking without any trouble. Hopefully.
Look at this guy. He's huge. Humongous. Honestly, probably.
He likes to like rest his body. Ooh. Rest that bod. Hopefully he doesn't bark because it'll be so loud in the microphone.
If he farts.
He barks.
Oh, if he barks. Oh, God.
It's gonna like break.
If someone's watching and he barks, I would feel really bad.
You like can't even see my body. I like kind of like blend into the back.
All black.
Well, not black, but like dark colors.
You know what? Let me refocus the camera. Hey guys, Overwatch all here. Yeah, I gotta figure out a new name for me. See, now it's gonna autofocus. I think he's like looking at himself.
He looks at himself in the mirror sometimes.
I love him. He's so ugly.
He's really tired. I'm tired too. I have to go home soon and work.
Yeah, whenever you got it, you gotta go. We can I'll end the stream. He really is. I'll put it back to cardio.
I keep hitting the mic. It's possible though that on stream it's not overly loud. I mean, it's just my earphones, because what I hear in my ears isn't the exact same that you're gonna hear in the video, because it's like I get the like direct sound from this, but when I'm trying to use, for some reason it just sounds bad. I'm trying to use my good headphones and have the sound come through this, but it I don't know why the sound doesn't sound good. I'm gonna put these in here.
Sure.
So you can get an idea. Yeah, I'll turn it up a little bit. Can you hear that?
Yeah, all I can hear is something like breathing.
How's this sound?
Stop, I don't like it.
It's too loud?
Mm-hmm.
Is the sound too loud?
It's just like too intense.
Oh, okay.
It like hurts my ears.
Yeah, I love that.
I don't like that.
Like, I've been doing that my whole life. I guess I like, before like ASMR was like coined as like a thing, or like just people knew about it, like. Oh yeah, I should crack my knuckles. They crack so good. Careful, we're gonna get canceled. They're gonna call me Shane Dawson 2.0.
True.
Go get the peanut butter.
$4.
I know.
Hey, girl, like...
Oh, okay. Don't talk about that on stream. But yeah, disgusting. Well, your body's not used to working as much, so plus like everything you do, it's God, I hope so, babe.
If not, I'm gonna... Like, I haven't called a doctor yet, but I really don't think they've
Oh, is that how it is?
Yeah.
You should call them anyways, just in case, you know.
Yeah.
It's always good to follow up.
And if there's nothing, then I'm probably gonna have to go back to the orthodontist and I don't know. She said I could do therapy for the muscles in my jaw or something.
I mean, I guess the first thing too would be to figure out if that's where the problem is, you know. I mean, it really does sound like that's the root cause of the problem, you know.
Is that a baby? That was a drill. Yeah, it was a baby. It sounded like.
I think my neighbors, I know they don't have a kid most of the time, but I think sometimes they have a kid, maybe they babysit or something.
Mm-hmm.
Everything that's necessary.
Yeah, I really need to start getting. It's really unprofessional the way I ship stuff. Cause I'm when somebody orders something from me, I can only give them the shipping estimate when everything's done and I bring it to the post office.
Hmm.
You know.
Yeah. Yeah. I guess it would make sense to. Mm-hmm.
And my fingers look weird.
Whose fingers don't look weird though?
Mine. They look they look like hot dogs. Is it because they're pink kind of? Everybody does that on the look when I do it, it's so long. Jesus. There's no way I could be one of those cute e-girls because my hands are so big.
What's that anime called where the guys have big hands? Yeah, you'd be like,
yeah. Yeah, yaoi hands, yeah, I do. They're huge. That is not cute at all. If I did that in a video, they'd be like,
you have to go like this.
They'd be like, is that bitch a 12-inch ruler?
You have to go like this.
No, they always go like this. I don't know what that's supposed to mean, but people always go like this.
It's like you're shy. Yeah. Like, oh, Naruto-kun. He doesn't love you. It's a little ulcer. I mean, it's.
It is gross. It's a little button.
You're not gross, Gus. You're beautiful. Is it bad that I just listening to sounds all the time?
I watch ASMR stuff.
But you watch the weird shit.
The eating stuff?
Yeah.
I think
really? I think that's the weird stuff. They're like, hey guys, we're just gonna eat this banana.
I have those, in anime when their knuckles are pink. That's what I have.
I don't think I've ever seen that.
No, it's their elbows and their shoulder and then their knuckles.
Or the tip of their nose.
Yeah, and it's pink. That's mine looks they're all pink.
I don't know if I've ever seen that in anime. Oh, baby. I think you're cute.
Thanks.
sneeze coming.
Oh no, that's a yawn. God, he's making me want to fall asleep.
This time change is really messing me up.
Yeah, me too. Surprisingly, it's actually affecting me. I think he's like almost passed out at this point.
Like if it says like that, there's one viewer that's not me, right? That's somebody else. Because we have like the thing open.
Are you watching me right now?
No.
No, then someone's watching. I don't know.
But then when I click on it, it doesn't say two viewers.
I don't know. It's sometimes it's like that. Like sometimes if I have my I'll start my thing and it says zero viewers and then I turn my stream thing like so I can monitor everything on and it takes a really long time till it says one viewer and then sometimes I have two. It's not like perfect, you know, so I mean, I often I like to creep into like people's streams, but I don't necessarily like want to interact with them, you know. Like I just kind of want to see what their deal is. So like, I don't know.
Oh, he's so disgusting like that. Oh, he's falling.
There's like someone watching this. Like they're trying to fall asleep. They're like, oh, finally sleep. Just it's falling. They're like, I'm awake now. This isn't a video for people to sleep, I don't think. Oh, I'm gonna shut it afterwards. I was gonna wear these pants to work, but I'm obviously not gonna do that anymore.
Hey, you're hungry. His nose is dripping. You're hungry? Do you wanna go home? Hey, you wanna go home?
Wanna go sleep? He's whack. Wet ass pug.
Is it WAP or WAP? It's WAP.
Is it WAP?
Wait.
No, it's wet ass pussy.
Yeah, but is it pronounced WAP or WAP?
I think it's WAP.
I don't know. Hey, buddy. You want
treat?
Should I give him a hot dog?
Yeah, let's give him a hot dog. This big boy deserves one. He did good. This is, for anyone watching or re-watching this as a VOD, Gus is a rescue, and he's a bit of a bad dog, not gonna lie.
He's not bad, he's just never...
socialized.
Yeah, he's never experienced the world, so he's very overwhelmed when we go out in public.
Yeah, because he's a bad dog.
Exactly.
Nah, I'm just kidding, he's not a bad dog. No, he just has a lot of training to do.
One thing to focus on, and he's really reactive when he sees dogs.
Yeah.
He wasn't potty trained. He'll eat anything, literally anything. We cannot have anything on the floor because anything like this size, he'll put it in his mouth and swallow it.
He's a bad dog.
So I just don't think he's ever had any, he's just never had any boundaries or basic training. And he's almost 2 years old, so he's getting to the point where it's gonna be a little harder now to train him. Not necessarily harder, but it's a lot easier when they're younger, less set in their ways. But his training's progressing really fast, so I'm really happy. We just signed up for some sessions with the trainer that I've known for a really long time. I used to somewhat be a dog trainer myself. I took a intensive 3-month training course in Victoria, BC, but the methods I learned there were really outdated and abusive, and I don't condone or use methods like that anymore. So now I'm with an all-positive trainer.
You should also mention that you did an animal behavior course.
Yeah, I did an animal behavior course coming up on 7 years ago now. The dog training course I did 10 years ago. 10 years ago, like, to the week, like, next week, I think. So I'm pretty old. And then I did that kind of training. People call it balanced training. It's where you, like, you'll do corrections and you'll also do like treats, but it's not really balanced. It's just like it still has the negative effects of corrections, because you're still using corrections. Balanced trainers like to say that they use treats to kind of cover up that they're using corrections, but they're still using corrections and it still has a side effects on the dogs. I would know. I used heavy corrections on my German Shepherd for about 4 years of his life, the results from that have basically been we don't really have a bond. I can tell that he doesn't really care for me, which makes me sad, but I mean, hey, we can't change the past. We're a lot better than how we used to be, but like when he meets strangers or other people in my family, I can tell he's a lot happier around them than he is with me.
And I mean, I think a good example is like me, you know?
Yeah, like he loves Ollie, because yeah, I think he's never, doesn't have 4 years of heavy corrections with Ollie, about 4 years after I did that, I realized that I was kind of ruining my dog. Like, I could see.
Go on.
No, what did you say?
I was going to say, you also have to, like, mention that you were a lot younger back then, so, like.
Yeah, I was 18 when I took that, training course, and I really think, like, I was, like, I kind of think of it like I was basically brainwashed.
Yeah, kind of.
Like, they trained us, like we were in the military. Like we would like get like punished and have corrections like from the teachers to ourselves if we were not correcting our dogs. Like I used to get put in like the back of the class because like Rick wasn't listening and I had to like be in the corner of the class like correcting Rick.
They make you wear a dunce cap.
A what? A dunce cap.
You know, like back in the day, like they would make kids sit in the corner. You'd wear like that pointy hat.
Oh no, Gus, it's okay. It's okay. Yeah.
He's gonna start barking. I'm just gonna lower this.
And then, yeah, I realized that I was. And they had also convinced me in that course that Rick was like a bad dog.
But he's literally like.
He literally is not. But like they had convinced me that he was like an aggressive bad dog, and he actually really wasn't.
He's honestly one of the world's sweetest dogs, and it's just really too bad that, like, you know, corrections were used on him.
Yeah, so, and then, you know, after realizing that I was kind of ruining my dog, like, I could, even without anybody telling me, I could see that our relationship was going down the drain, and that I was, like, breaking any bonds I could possibly have with him. By keeping on doing this type of training. So I took a animal behavior apprenticeship for positive training, and that really like changed my life.
Mm-hmm.
And changed Rick's life, I should say too.
Yeah, definitely for the better.
Yeah. But I mean, that was a long time ago, and I don't consider myself a trainer anymore. Like when I got Gus, and he started showing some like reactivity on leash, I was like, whoa, like I don't even know how to deal with addiction. So, like, right away I contacted my friend and I was like, sign me up. Go. I wanna do lessons and yeah, he's doing really good and we were out today doing some training. And I already kind of like know how to do like pretty good timing and read body language pretty good, so the training is going a lot faster than if I was like a first time dog owner and didn't know what I was doing.
Yeah, that's true.
So little Gus's story and a little bit of my story. Hey, little pugs. And Ollie gets to be along for the ride.
I have the best, I don't have to like worry about any of the like the important stuff, and I just get to like
just get the benefit.
The benefits, yeah.
You don't have to put any in any of the work.
Exactly. I mean, I help, you know. I take him out to pee every now and then. And I give him cuddles, keep him distracted.
Yeah, that's what, I mean, obviously it's amazing to rescue dogs, but you also have to be aware that you don't know their backgrounds and, you know, a lot of times they're going to need, you know, some help with becoming little good boys. I would really suggest like reaching out to a trainer, because it just kind of takes the stress off of you. Of like, well, for me it was kind of like took the stress off of setting everything up initially and giving myself like a plan and stuff. Like the trainer gives me the plan and I just follow through, because I'm working full time on my own stuff and I'm still working at my day job, so I don't really have like the mental capacity right now to be like setting myself up a training plan for him. So it's easier to hire a trainer and they help you with all that.
Just noticed there's this gray bar.
It's not there on the other side.
Yeah, this is the source and this is the
Anyways, I think when I get going, I think I've yapped enough.
Yeah, for sure.
You agree that I've yapped enough?
I like listening to you, especially through this. Sounds,
oh, yeah?
Yeah, sounds pretty sick.
Give me the headphones and you talk to me. I want to hear what it sounds like.
Hey, I'm Caleb. Oh no, sorry. He does more like a Patrick Star voice. It's like,
calm down. And the bitch in the back.
No, it's a. Hey, I'm Caleb.
Wait, no, it's like Goofy. My kids are listening to Kids Bop. No, that's.
My kids are listening to Kids Bop.
And the bitch in the back.
She gotta calm down.
Calm down.
Is that what she does?
Yeah.
Calm down.
Calm down. So good.
Just as a reference, okay, Gus. I'm gonna kick this dog. No, just completely joking. Completely. I say abusive stuff, but it's 100% a joke. What was I gonna say? There's this video where this guy reviews people on TikTok who are trying to sound like Corpse, and they're literally it's the funniest shit ever. What's the guy's name that does that?
I don't know. They're like,
it's so funny. They always start off, they're like, and then they're like, hey. and they always get close to the mic. They're like, hey,
ew,
my name's.
Stop.
Like, this is my real
stop.
Voice.
Stop. It's so gross. I can't listen to it.
Hey.
Stop. Wait, do the French voice.
Like the Parisian one?
Yeah.
Ouais, salut. Je m'appelle Overwatch Olivier. Et là, on va jouer du Overwatch. Ça va être trop cool, trop chouette. So, la gang, si vous voulez vous joindre, Ça va être super cool, mais premièrement, donne-moi un petit moment.
Bonjour tout le monde. Je vais vous montrer comment faire un petit sac.
Ouais, ouais, c'est ça, trop cool.
That's the only sentence I know how to say.
Hey. Can I hear what that sounds like?
Yeah.
Is it super loud? Are people gonna get annoyed or is it?
It's not that loud, but it's very intense.
Hey. Oh god, that sounds so bad. Hey, my name's Caleb. This is my real voice. Hey.
We're constantly abusing Gus with kisses.
He deserves it. He's a bad dog. Ew. Nasty. Never kiss him.
You kiss me anyways.
Yeah. Look at this little sponge on the face he has. All squished.
No. He's like an old man.
He's an old man.
Ew, a hair just landed on his nose and then he pushed it off. He hates me.
He definitely hates. Does.
Actually, no, he doesn't. He's pretty attached.
Yeah, he's super attached.
You don't realize like how attached they are until you're like out in public, kind of. Like when I did my first training session and like the trainer took the leash and then he like kind of wasn't following her and he was just kind of like watching me. I was like, fuck, you actually do care. God damn.
And the bitch in the back.
The bitch in the back.
The bitch in the back.
Calm down. Anyways, I gotta get going.
Okay.
Calm down.
Sorry.
I guess we'll start working at one. Then I'll work all after.
Oh, no. Just for the fun of it, like how during. I respect my gaming chair, which is why I put a towel on it. And I already took a shower today, so I can wash it another time. Okay. Well, I guess this is goodbye. Whoops. All right. Let me just at least autofocus for this little goodbye. Ah, shit, it's out of focus on the mic.
Is it over?
Glitch, Olivier. No, it's not over. I'm just gonna say a little goodbye. So if anybody's watching this as a VOD, I wish you guys all a very good day, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Hey. Yo.
You gonna get tips?
Oh, okay. Hey, what's a realistic goal? Let's say 50 followers, 100 followers, and I'll twerk on camera. Babe, you hear that?
What?
I'm like 100 followers, and I'll twerk on camera.
You don't have an answer.
I can't twerk. I've tried before. All right. Have a great day. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye-bye.
Hey, I'm Caleb.